आई एम डॉक्टर संजीव गुलाटी, डायरेक्टर नेफ्रोलॉजी एंड किडनी ट्रांसप्लांट, फोर्टिस ग्रुप ऑफ हॉस्पिटल्स, NCR. टुडे वील डिस्कस 7 मिथ्स अबाउट कोविड वैक्सीनेशन एंड किडनी पेशेंट्स. फर्स्ट, आई हैव हिस्ट्री ऑफ एलर्जीज, आई कैनॉट टेक अ वैक्सीन. आई थिंक दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली अनट्रू. मेनी ऑफ अस हैव हिस्ट्री ऑफ माइनर एलर्जीज एंड वी हैव हैड ऑल काइंड ऑफ वैक्सीनेशंस बिफोर. द ओनली पर्सन हु नीड नॉट टेक a second dose of COVID vaccine is if you have reacted to the first dose of the same COVID vaccine. The risk-benefit ratio is highly in favor of COVID vaccine. Second, I have developed fever after taking COVID vaccine. I think I have got COVID. This is again untrue. You cannot develop COVID following vaccination. The COVID vaccine either contains a killed virus or it contains an adenovirus with a spike protein. It may also contain an mRNA-based vaccine. None of these vaccines contain a live COVID virus. Otherwise, it would not have been approved for clinical use. You may develop fever after vaccine, but it is because of the reaction of your immune system to the vaccine, which is generating antibodies. So you can take Crocin for that, but definitely you cannot develop COVID following vaccination. Now we have experience of thousands of patients all over the world, and none of these patients, either the volunteers during the trial phase of the vaccine as well as now the actual vaccination, has shown that anybody got COVID following vaccination. Next, I am on blood thinners. I cannot take COVID vaccine. I don't think that's true. You can stop blood thinners for a day. Please go ahead with the vaccine after that, because of your comorbidities of your heart condition, you are at high risk for developing complications following COVID. So blood thinners are not a contraindication again for COVID vaccine. Next, I'm a dialysis patient. It is unsafe for me. This is again untrue. Experience has shown that dialysis patients are at the highest risk of dying because of COVID infections. They have to travel to a dialysis center 3 times a week. They come in contact with multiple healthcare workers, including during travel, they can come in contact with the taxi drivers and other people. So they are at very high risk of COVID. And our experience has shown that 1/3 of the dialysis patients have lost their lives because of COVID infection. So I think dialysis patients should actually be prioritized for COVID vaccination, and we have recommended the same to the government. Next, I'm a kidney transplant patient. It is unsafe for me to take a COVID vaccine. This is again untrue. We have been doing vaccinations for kidney transplant patients for last so many years. The only issue is with the live virus vaccines, and COVID vaccine is not a live viral vaccine like varicella or polio. It is like an influenza vaccine which you have been getting all these years. So you should go ahead with the vaccine. At present, there is some data to suggest that Covishield vaccine may be better than Covaxin for kidney transplant patients. But as soon as more data is available, I'm sure we'll have safety clearances even for the Covaxin. Next, I've had COVID before. I've developed antibodies. I do not need a vaccine. A lot of our kidney patients have developed COVID, have recovered from that, and some of you, I'm sure, have had COVID antibodies too. But the research studies have shown that these antibodies are short-lasting. So yes, you should go ahead for COVID vaccination. The only precaution that we are suggesting, and based again on research studies, is that you could wait about 3 months after your last COVID vaccination, because you have some amount of antibodies that will protect you till then. After 3 months, the antibodies start going down, and so you should get those 2 doses. Last and the 7th, I have already taken 2 good doses of COVID vaccine, and now I can roam around freely. I do not need masks or social distancing. This is again untrue. None of the vaccines that are available are 100% effective. The antibodies that you may develop may also wane over time, and it is quite possible that you may require annual doses like of these vaccine, like the influenza vaccine. So we are awaiting further research, especially about kidney patients, as to what is the efficacy. The efficacy is definitely lower, and the antibody levels may also be lower than the general population. So all of you, even after getting a vaccine, should practice SMS. S stands for social distancing, M stands for mask, and S stands for again sanitization or hand washing. So please get your vaccination done and stay safe and healthy during the pandemic. Thank you.